Hey guys, Satyendra here, and in today's video we are going to create a spring in which both ends are grounded, and then the spring is having a constant pitch, and then the spring is flexible. And other than this, some interesting thing, like if you want to add some more coils at the ground end. So to create this spring we will use helical sweep, and there are three parameters in helical sweep to create a spring. As I edit this, the first one is spring height. So spring height you will get here. If I make it normal, this gap between this, in between top length to spring height, this length is the spring height. Say okay. So this is the first parameter. Then second parameter is the wire dia. You see the wire dia is here, it is 5. And then the third one is the pitch. So pitch is here. There are two different pitch value here. One is pitch 5 and the second one is pitch 20. So this kind of spring will be created by using variable pitch. And again, to add variable pitch in helical sweep, we have three different ways. First way is by value, then second way is by reference, and then third way is by ratio. So I'll be doing this video by using by reference method. So practically, if you see any spring, that will be in between 270 to 300 degree grounded. To create a grounded area, we have used this spring height plane and the top plane to cut the material in the top and in the bottom. If you take the spring height in between these two plane, here the spring height is taken in between this top plane and spring height plane. So if you are taking a height like this, then you will get only the 180 degree grounded portion, grounded area. But if you see this spring here, I have taken little extra. You can see here it is coming out of this reference. So I have taken little extra from both sides to make the area, grounded area, around 290 degree. So this is the trick. Actually, if you want to increase the grounded area, you need to take little extra both the ends. So to create this spring, I will be using helical sweep, and inside the helical sweep, to assign variable pitch, I will go for by reference method. So let's get started. I will directly go to new. I will type spring 3. Say OK. Now first I'll create one axis so that it will be helpful while assembling this spring inside the assembly. It is done. And then one plane I will create to specify the total height of the spring. So I'll just go for plane. I will take top plane as a reference, and I will make it 100. The total length is 100. Okay. So you can see that one plane got created here. I will just rename it as spring underscore height. I have other data ready here. See, my spring height or spring length is 100, then wire dia is 5, and then I need the constant pitch as 25. So I will try to maintain all these three values. So I have already created spring height as 100. Now I will directly jump to helical sweep. I'll select plane to specify the spring height. I'll say sketch, make it normal. Now I need the grounded angle as 280 or 290 degrees. So I'll just take this spring height plane as a reference, and axis of revolution. Then I'll specify the total height. I will take little extra both sides, as I told you. this will be 50, and this is the total height. So from this reference to this reference it is 100. I'll be taking little extra, but before that I will just create some reference point. I will use sketch point, or let us use this datum point. Okay, so here I have created 4 points. These points are the location to vary the pitch. See, the by default we get 2 points. This is the start point for spring and this is the end point for spring. So as I know that my wire die is 5, I will just take the distance from this point to this point is 5, and again from here to here is 5. The same thing, same distance I will create here also, and then one more dimension I will create from here till here. So this is the extra portion which will be added in the grounded area. Again, this side also I will create a dimension in the same way, because both the end has to be grounded. And from here till here. So I will assign all the things. Now I will just make it equal, because this end and this end, both ends are having grounded area, then it will be equal. So if I make this dimension equal to this dimension, then this dimension is equal to this dimension, and then this dimension is equal to this dimension. So if I make this 3 dimension equal, then it will reduce the relations which I am going to assign in the spring. This value will be this is somewhat 30% of the wire dia. So my wire dia is 5, then 30% of that will be 1.5. just I'll type 1.5. Okay, so now once again I'll explain the logic. See, my spring is getting started from here. So to touch the wire with each other from first point to second point, we need to keep the pitch value as wire dia, and then from second point the pitch value is wire dia, that is 5. And then from second point to third point, it has to vary from 5 to 25. It has to change from 5 to 25. Okay. And if the third point is having 25 pitch value, and the fourth point again is having 25 pitch value, then it will be constant till here. Then again vice versa, from here 25 to 5, it will get reduced. And again from 5 to 5, it will go. And then just because of this, because it is 5 both end, it will touch each other. So this is what the whole logic behind this variable pitch inside the helical sweep. I just say okay, and I'll go directly for wire dia. Here I will be assigning the wire dia, which is 5. I'll just make it 5. And I'll say okay. Now you can see that it is constant here, because we haven't applied the pitch. Now I will apply the pitch in all the points. Again, there will be start point and end point. This is the start point and end point. And then there are 4 different points which we have already assigned here. We have created here. And all those points will be going by a reference method, so that we can directly select these points. I will directly go for this point. And then 4th point, which is again by reference, which is this one, and then 5th and 6th will be somewhere here. I will again select by reference method, and I will select this, and then the last pitch is by reference, and this is the point. So I have assigned all the pitch value for all the reference point. Now the start will be 5, then end will be also 5, then the third point is somewhere here. So this first point is 5, Then second point, or here it is showing the third point, will be also equal to 5. Then go for fourth point here in the list, which is third point here. So this has to be 25. Make it 25. Now you can understand that from 5 to 5, it is constant, so it is touching. And then from 5 to 25, it is varying, so it start varying from here. Then again, if you see this spring, the fifth point here or the fourth point here will be again 25. Then the last point will be 5. So this is how you need to add the variable pitch for the spring. Now I'll just say okay. Now you can see that your spring is almost ready. Then just select the top plane and try to make it ground. Solidify it so that it will remove the material. Now you can see that it is removing around 290 degree. I say okay. And select this plane also and say solidify. I remove that. So now you can understand that why I created this plane. This plane I created to make the spring grounded and to assign the spring height with reference to this plane. So that when I make this spring flexible, this plane should move along with the spring, and all the time my top end should be grounded. Now it is the time to assign some relation to the spring before making the spring flexible. But before that, let us rename some of the things, like okay, so I will go for this dimension properties. But before this, just go for renaming and copy this, and now go for dimension properties and make this DO as spring height and say okay. Then some other things like your location is this one. Okay, so here I will rename. See, this area is like my ground area, so I will just go for properties and I'll change it as ground. And then in display I will make it symbol, and this point and this point are my location, and this is made equal here. So my location 1 or point 1, I'll just go for properties, I will make it point 1, and here also symbol, so okay, and this also as point 2. Point 2, and here I will make it a symbol. So I have renamed my two locations as point 1 and point 2, and the starting area is the ground area. Just isn't it? Other than this, I will just rename this pitch. So this is the first one. I'll just go for properties. It is showing D11, so I need to rename as pitch, P-I-T-C-H, pitch 1. This is my pitch 1. Okay. And then this is pitch 2. Pitch 2, okay. This is this I'll leave. I will make this as pitch 3. This as pitch 4. Okay. This as pitch 4. And then this one I will make pitch 5. Pitch 5, and then the last one is this, and this one I'll make pitch 6. say okay, regenerate, and rename this wire. So this has to be wire dia. I will make it wire dia underscore dia, and this I want to see as a symbol, so I will make this say okay, regenerate and save. Now I'll directly jump to relation, and here again I will select this and say done. Then point one is the first location is equal to wire dia. Then second point two is also equal to wire dia. So these two points, because it has to touch, then it has to be wire dia. The location, this is the gap distance I'm specifying by this relation. So from here to here also this gap should be equal to wire dia. Okay, so location is done. Now I'll say enter. Now the pitch value by this relation, so I'll just go with this, the first one. So pitch one will be equal to wire dia. Okay, and then pitch 2, from here it is 5 and here also it is 5, that is why it will be touching. Then this pitch will be this is not the wire dia, from here to here it is wire dia, it is 5 to 5, here it is 25, so that relation will be somewhat different. So again for second pitch is this pitch 2 is equal to wire dia. Then third pitch is my this pitch, okay, third pitch, this is also equal to wire dia. And then the fourth pitch, this one is also equal to wire dia. Okay, so then I'll just enter in. Then this one, the pitch 4 is not equal to wire dia because it is 25. So the pitch 4 is dependent upon the total height of this spring. So the relation will be pitch 5 is equal to, I need 25, the total height is 100. So if I make it 100 divided by 4, then it will become 25. So I'll just click this spring height and I'll say pitch 5 is equal to this divided by 4. And this pitch 6 is also same, so pitch 6 is equal to spring height divided by 4. Now this logic you can understand, I believe. Then the grounded area. The grounded area has to be related with the relation. So I'll say ground is equal to, it should always be 30% of wire dia preferable. So make it relate with wire dia. So I'll make ground is equal to wire dia multiplied by 30%, which is 0.3. So my relation is done. I believe I'll just verify everything looks okay. And then I will add one text here on the top. Okay. So this is the text. The text says wire dia is the minimum pitch required to ground the coil, and then location 1, or I can say point 1, point, yeah, point 1 is equal to wire dia into number of grounded coil. So here I will just make, I will tell you why I am doing this into 1. Okay, it is very interesting. I'm just trying to make this point equal to wire dia into 1. So point 1 is the gap between this. If I make 2, then this gap will be double. If I make 3, then this point gap will be triple. But this point 2 will be same wire dia, it won't change. So if I want to add some more grounded coil, just like this spring, you can see here, this is having 3 coils in both ground ends. So if I need something like this, if I need 2 coils here, then that will be very helpful. Come to the spring 3, regenerate and save. Now let us try the relation. Go to relations and change it from 1 to 3 and say OK. Regenerate. Now you have three coils grounded both the end. Make it front and now you can see. So if I change the dimension of this, I will make it 50 and regenerate. Now you can see that it is getting reduced, because if the height is 100 and then pitch is 25, then now the pitch should be 12.5. So let us go and edit this and see the pitch value. You can see it is 12.5, but top and bottom ends are still 5, and you can see here nothing is editable because all are driven from our relation. Okay, so now once again we'll try. We'll just change the height of this spring from here to 200. Let us make it 200. What result we are getting? Again, you see the pitch value is changing. Now regenerate it. Now let us make this spring as a flexible component. Assemble inside a assembly. So make it 100. Okay. So this is my spring. I just regenerate. You can color this spring as you wish. So now let us make this spring flexible. So to make this spring flexible, we have very nice option inside the file prepare and model properties. You can see there is a text called flexible here, not defined. So just say change and define it. So in this spring, we all know that the flexible part is the height of the spring. So I will directly jump to height and I'll select this dimension and say okay. So now your height is flexible. You say okay and then you save it. Now the same spring I'm going to assemble in this assembly, okay, three times. So let us hide these three spring for time being. So we have three different locations to assemble the spring. So let us assemble spring three one by one. It is asking for something. Model spring 3 has predefined flexibility. Would you like to use this flexible component definition? Yes, I want to use this. Now it is saying that this 100 is flexible. So which way you want to make it flexible? There are different ways here. Curve length, distance, angle, this, that. So for me, it is distance. I will select distance. And I will say distance as this surface to this surface. I say okay. Say okay. Now your spring is flexible. Now just assemble it. I will select the bottom surface to this, and then second constraint is the axis, this axis to this, and this one I'll make it coincident. Say okay. Now you see it got squeezed here. Now the second time again I will assemble the same spring, again say yes, and this time by value, again I will say by distance, and this time I will select a different distance from here till here. So this is 100, I will say okay, say okay, and now I will select this bottom surface which will meet here, and then this to this axis. And again for axis, we need to say coincident, say okay, and then the third time I am going to assemble the same spring. So I will just bring the spring, say yes, then again by distance, and I will sign from this distance, this surface to this surface, and say okay, that's it. I will select this surface for this, and then this axis. To this, we'll make it constant. So now you can see that the same spring is assembled three times here. But because this spring is having flexible property, it is following all the surfaces relevant to the position. So this is the way you can make your spring flexible, you can make your spring grounded, and you can vary the pitch of your spring applying the relations. So this is it, guys. Now like this video if the video is helpful, share this video with your friends, and subscribe my channel for further updates.